Friends, so this is GV Shukumar. Thanks for watching my videos. And many people actually have asked me about so how you completed or how you cleared the SAP EWM certification. And actually, you asked me to post the video in English, right? So, I mean, you know, right? Actually, currently we are having when SAP is providing S4 EWM 2020 version. And in that actually, so you need to go through all the documents. First, I like to say actually, please go through EWM 100, 110, 120, 130, and the 140 kind of, in all this labor management, everything, right? Actually, all the documents, whatever, I mean, you can, it is available in the S4 Learning, S4, that is, SAP Learning Hub portal. Where you can find actually the certification material, you can download that, and then actually you can start preparing for the EWM certification. So important thing actually, the examination hours is nearly 3 hours. I mean, it's 3 hours, and in examination actually online examination they are asking 80 questions. So important point here is actually you can have the option to select either actually the direct classroom kind of training or online kind of training, and also the certification is either online or you can have a you can go to the examination center. There you can take the authorized learning partner kind of thing, so there you can actually take the exam. So important, and also important thing actually, your internet should be actually, if you are taking the online exam, so your internet should always be actually in good condition. So normally when you are installing the software, right, actually the question mark software actually provided by SAP, actually it will check for the audio quality, video quality, and then broadband speed, everything. Actually it will check for the headphone quality, everything it will check, and if it is everything is okay, then only you are allowed to continue the exam. So when coming to the topics, so what topics actually they are mostly covering in this examination, right? So you need to go through actually the difference between what is earlier standalone EWM and the current actually S4HANA embedded EWM, right? So you need to know the difference first, and then actually you need to know how EWM is integrated with ECC or actually S4HANA if it is standalone, or if it is actually say from how the ERP is connecting with EWM, what are the delivery, how the delivery documents are integrated, how the document flow is moving here and there. And then actually you need to concentrate on say for example the item category, document type, and then actually document category. And then actually you need to concentrate on the inbound delivery part, outbound delivery part, and internal warehouse operations. And then actually you need to study about actually the wave creation, automatic or manual wave creations, how warehouse templates are created, how waves are generated, how you confirm the warehouse order, details on process oriented storage control and layout oriented storage control, what is a resource, what is a EWM queue. So all these kind of topics here, it is good to study. And also you need to know about warehouse order creation rule, WOCR. So how all this linkage is the warehouse process template, warehouse task, and how the wave or warehouse order creation rule, and then actually the warehouse order, everything is created, and actually whether actually currently the inbound notification is available in S4HANA or not, how this that is outbound delivery order and outbound delivery are linked, still it is used in use or not. And so the RF part, what are the configurations required, how you, in what application you are confirming the task using the RF, and how it is better compared to our earlier standalone EWM. So all these things you need to study. So currently actually SAP is providing actually S4 EWM 1909 as well as current version is actually 2020. So I have cleared actually S4 EWM 2020. That is actually, so to my understanding, if you go through all the PDF documents, whatever I told, right, actually, so that will help you to clear all the subject without any hassle. So it is a, I mean, I can say it's easy one. Actually, I'm not seeing any big difficulty. So you need to know about the topics I have told, right? Actually, they are covering 10% to 12% in maximum. Actually 15% they will cover. So if you are good in that, actually you can complete the exam within maximum actually 1 hour 30 minutes, at max actually 2 hours. Within 2 hours you can complete, and you can find the time to just go through the whatever you have answered, so whether it is correct or not. So you can check with all the questions. Sometimes actually it is important to note, for some few questions actually three answers may be right. Out of 5 or out of 4, 3 answers may be right. So you need to thoroughly, or you need to slowly, first you need to read the questions very thoroughly and then plan to answer all these questions. So if you are very good in, if you are confident, then you can tick the particular question. And if you are having doubt, actually then actually say, for example, you, for the time being, you are selecting some answers and you need to say actually revise or go through the questions once again after completing. Without avoiding to stand on a particular question, because actually if you see the time clock in the right hand side corner, concentration will go. Actually we will think actually we need to finish our exam within the stipulated time. So our concentration will go on the timing run. The clock run. So actually we need to be more thorough in that area. Don't look after the timing run or a clock run. The digital timer is continuously running. So when it is going down and down, actually you will get more tension. But actually my suggestion is thoroughly read all these questions, thoroughly read PDF, thoroughly read actually the questions while taking the examination. That will help you to avoid unnecessary tension. You can able to get actually easily get actually 70 to 80% actually. So that is not a big task. And if you are reading many times and you are thorough, getting 90% also, or 90 to 95% also, not a big deal. So and then actually you need to know about actually the interleaving, special operations, yard management. See actually how the EWM is connected to yard management, how the EWM is having direct integration with the EWM is integrated with production process, direct production integration. So during the production integration, what document will create? And then actually what are the important theory apps related to EWM, and what are the tails to be given? So all these things actually you need to thoroughly go through all the documents. And if you are having hands-on experience, that definitely help you to know. Reading the book is very much better. Actually, hands-on is always better. So, and the second thing, actually, you can go through that some training kind of thing, or actually you can practice in the system. So you can get a license from SAP, or actually those who are providing actually SAP license, right, authorized partners. You can get the system access, practice very well, and then actually you can get confidence in attending examination. But sure, actually attending examination is somewhat different from working in the real time. Working in the real time, you need a complete business process, and in case of questions actually in the examination, it is not that much big a deal. So you can easily answer all the questions actually. So it is very simple actually. Say for example, it is how the document category is linked, how the ECC is linked with EWM, whether a SIF is integrated, SIF is a through SIF, or actually how the IDOC is to be constructed. and see actually how the RF menu management is working. And see, as a EWM, actually, even MFS also very important. So how you are directly integrating PLC, programmer logic control, with the SAP EWM, how it speaks, whether it is an RFC connection, so do we need HTTP connection, all these kind of questions were important. So then actually I can say how EWM is integrated with QM. So what are the set of master data required? So you need to concentrate first on the EWM master data, how EWM is connected with ERP or external ERP systems, and what are the process steps required for running inbound, outbound, internal operations, how it is integrated with the production, how it is integrated with QM, and say how the outbound that is order or anything is integrated with EWM, how inbound is integrated. So whether we need a SIF or not, RF management, and then MFS, and other than that actually regarding the Fiori management, UI path and everything. So related, I mean, especially related to EWM, right? Actually that is important. And then actually as already told, wave generation, warehouse process template, warehouse task, how warehouse task is confirmed, how what is the warehouse order confirmation rule, how the warehouse orders are confirmed or completed. And then actually important thing, actually the stock adjustments between ECC and EWM to synchronize both the systems. And so we have actually a lot of adjustments are there, right, between ECC and EWM. So all these things part of the examination. So you need to thoroughly labor management, again, one among things, labor management is also important. But compared to other areas, actually, but one thing, actually, you need to secure equal good marks in all the areas, then only you will get a good rating and get a pass mark, right? Actually, if you are not answering or not getting the required mark in a particular topic of interest, then actually your score, utmost score will be go down. So these are the important things actually you need to consider in the mind. So I am not saying it is a tough examination. It is little bit easy only if you are reading thoroughly the entire end-to-end books. So in SAP currently actually they are charging actually for one time CER-001 mode, actually one time attempt, they are charging 16,889, and with the GST includes some 3,000 plus, so totally 9,889 something they are charging. And for six times attempt, the code name is CER-006, then actually you can you need to pay some 50 plus GST is there. So if six times attempts, actually even if you say for example if you clear in the first attempt itself, you can use that actually attempts actually for clearing further examination. You can, if you are good in all subjects, you can take six different SAP modules. And say for example some people will face the first time they will get a failure mark, and the second time they will clear, right? Actually for that only SAP is doing. And so you can check all the course details and examination details, timing, cost, everything, procedures and everything, right, in learning.sap.com portal. And so currently for WM certification is not there currently, only for cloud we have WM. But EWM, again actually when you are saying EWM, actually say for EWM, even for SAP Activate, they are not giving any expiry date mentioned in the certificate. Only for say specialist cloud project management, project manager cloud, actually so they are giving validity date for 5 years. Say if you are clearing in 2023, your certification will be valid till 2028. So these are the information I like to furnish. Other than that, actually those who people actually know about examination, how to take SAP examination, right, very well know that, right? Actually you can go through all the topics or information given in the SAP portal. Say during the examination, actually you need to provide government cards, government provided ID proofs, either actually Aadhaar card or driving license or PAN card. So SAP person will verify that, and then actually they will ask you to rotate, show 360 degree view of the room, and no person, I mean external person, should be added to help you. So those kind of fraudulent activity will result in termination of exam. And then actually digital or the paper bound actually material should be placed near your desk or in the room, and no mobile is allowed. Actually you need to switch off or mute the mobile and place it at some distance, not within the room. And no electronic devices, actually digital reader or nothing, Amazon, Kindle, those kind of stuff should not be entertained to keep you in the desk. And you need to show that desk left and right, and then the wall or opposite. When you are placing, when you are sitting towards the wall or anything, actually they will ask you to show your opposite side, back and front and back, left and right, and then desk cleanliness. So only the power source is allowed, or mouse pad. In mouse pad, actually there is no text writing should be there. No text should be found. So everything is clean. And they will ask everything actually. If your name is not correct in one, differ from one ID card to another, they will ask you to support naming verification using the third ID card. So those kind of normal steps you can see. And also you cannot loudly read the questions. Say that they thought actually you are giving an hint or giving some information so that an external person can will give you the answer, right? Those kind of things should not be allowed. Only headphone should be allowed, and the secondary laptop should not be switched on, or not, I mean no other electronic device should be placed near to your examination laptop, right? So that is very important. And other than that, actually, so they will give the terms and policies, how much time they are giving for each questions, or what is the duration of the examination. Everything they will give you. And after completing the examination, actually, you can submit that. You can find the exact score of the exam in each topic, and how much percentage in total you secured. And this examination person from SAP, actually, once you complete, you can inform them that actually you are completed and you pass the examination. We can close the session. Then actually they will allow you to close it. Actually they will stop the screen sharing. You need to first screen share screen with them. They will check all the whether actually any supporting document or SAP documents available in your desktop or screen. They will check everything. And next, actually, after completing, you need to submit the survey. How you face the examination? What is your experience? The experience about with the SAP person who is conducting, helping, supporting the exam, examination process. So all these things are questioned, and you need to give answer. And once you submit, the total exam will over. And they will provide actually the certificate link, and then badge and everything. You can check using the link. Actually you can click and verify the badge, and then either you can, the SAP is providing the option to share in LinkedIn social website, that is LinkedIn, Facebook or Twitter, or you can download that. They can give the hard code of the program, you can send it through your email. So all these things matter. So I hope actually the details have given Chad about the SAP certification exam is very useful for everyone. Thanks friends. If you need lot of details, I'm ready to share the information. So now actually I have completed actually SAP MM EWM and then SAP Activate Project Management and senior specialist in cloud SAP Activate Project Management. So completed 4 examinations. So definitely actually you will get a confidence if you complete the examination. Thanks friends, thanks for watching my videos. This is GV Shivakumar signing off.